make a sound. One more. Breathing in. Lengthening a little bit more the back of the neck. And breathing out. Slide the ribs in, stomach, and the thigh. And then let's just stretch the arms. Stretch first the wrists, the fingers, and lengthen the arms up by your ears as you breathe in. Now, as you breathe out, keep the shoulders down, plug them down the stomach, the ribs, keep the breath going. And do about three more, breathing in. Stretch up. As you breathe out, slide the shoulders down. And notice also, when the arms go up, usually this happens to me. I breathe in, my ribs go back. So I need to push or hug my ribs in a little bit, even though they do open out. And then breathe out, hug them in even more. So don't let them flare out totally so that your posture goes. And that's what I mean on the mat, when the arms are going back, doing abdominals, keep the ribs on the floor, exhale, don't let them spread out that much. One more, breathing in. And let's keep the arms up, just slide the shoulders up, and then down again. And this happens again, so as you breathe in, and you breathe out and slide the shoulders down, the ribs go back, keep them on top of your hips. Do two more. One more, breathe in. And breathe out, plug them down, the shoulders, and bring your hands behind your head and just stretch the neck here. Keep your head down for now. So for a couple of breaths, just stretch your neck by looking down and breathing out, trying to roll a little bit further down each time you breathe out. You want to push your pubic bone forward, still squeeze your inner thighs, suck your stomach in, and keep going down a little bit more if you can on every breath out. And when you can't go down anymore, pushing your hips forward, release your arms, let them hang, and roll down one vertebra at a time into a forward fold. And once you're down, try and get your hands on the floor, stomach near your thighs, turn the head to the right, to the left, nod it a couple of times, and then as you breathe out, roll back up, and again, take your time, squeeze the stomach back, and lengthen the back of the neck, not the chin. And we're doing two more in your own rhythm. So breathe in, try and grow. Breathe out, drop the head, then the shoulders. Squeeze the stomach back, bend the knees. Tilt the tailbone up, stomach by your thighs, hands on the floor, turn the head right, turn it to the left, nod it, and then roll up. On your breath out. We're doing one more, but we're staying down. So breathe in and breathe out. Roll your head, your shoulders, just like before. Just we're staying a little bit longer in that forward stretch. So once you're down there again, turn your head right and left, nod it, and then stay there. See if you can put your hands again behind your head, interlace your fingers and pull your head down towards the floor or towards your shins. Try and lift the hips up, suck the stomach in, stretch a little bit more. And then sway a little bit right and left here. When you're ready, release the arms down and roll back up. Squeeze the stomach in, plug the shoulders down. One vertebra at a time. Nice. Hi, Carla. Now we're just going to tilt the head to the side. So as you breathe out, let it drop to the right and breathe in back to center. Just remember to point your nose always to the front and try not to move your shoulders. So the shoulders shouldn't be lifting or dropping. It's just isolating the head movement. Breathing in at the top and breathing out at the side. Let's do two more and then we'll stop on the left side. And a tilt. So breathing in at the top and breathing out. Keep your head on the left side in a tilt and then do a semicircle. Let it roll down towards the floor and then look at the world to the right side in a tilt. That's it. And then let it roll again. Try and work with gravity here and your breath out. Breathe in, let it hover to a tilt. Breathe out, let it drop. Feel the back of the body stretch. Maybe increase it so that the shoulders are involved. Now roll the shoulders a little bit and then come into the side. Whatever feels good, just be intuitive. Just try and end with your head tilted in that same shape, movement as before. Relax in. And we're going to end to the right. So when you come to a tilt to the right, hold it there. And grab your head again with the right hand. Pull it a little bit further, involving your shoulders, your ribs. Come into that side bend. That's it. Breathing in, coming back up. We'll do two more. So as you breathe out, first the head. Roll into the side. One more, we'll hold it there. So as you breathe out to the side, hold it there. See if you can push the feet down, the hips forward, slightly to the right with the left of the hips, and bring the right shoulder forward a little bit more. Four more seconds there, three. Melt a little bit more the head, go on a little bit more. And coming back up, breathe in, and just release. Let's go to the other side. So grabbing the head, pull the head just first, hold it there. And then let's go into a side bend. Exhaling. Try to not hide the back shoulder, the bottom shoulder. Bring it forward a little bit more, Carla. That's it. And then breathe in, come back up. So you're trying to be symmetrical always to the front. So as you exhale, come into the side bend. Push the feet down, the hips to the right and forward. And breathe in. One more. Breathing out to the side. If you can hold it there and try and keep long in the stomach, hug the ribs in, bring that bottom shoulder forward, also the right hip forward. Keep breathing, see if you can relax a little bit more into that stretch. Lovely, and then come back up. Inhale at the top, nice. Just release the arms, put them behind your head, behind your back. And we're gonna turn the head to the right now. Just turn it all the way right, breathe out, breathe in back to center. And then all the way to the left. Try not to move your shoulders, but do move your eyes as you turn the head. So breathe out, turn the eyes to the right corner of the eyes, and then breathe in back to center, and then turn your eyes to the left. Let's do two more, two last ones. Breathing out to the side. Breathe in to the center. One more, breathing out. And breathing in. And let's just do a little twist with the hands on our shoulders now. Remember to look forward and just try and move your ribs, but not your hips, not your head. Keep your elbows broad and squeeze your inner thigh, squeeze that block. It shouldn't move. So if you see that your block is moving, try and keep it still. So breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Nice. And four more, and three. And two, and one. Hold it in the center, lift the elbows up and behind you. Breathe in, in front, and hold that drop. Okay, breathing in, up, behind, in front, exhale. One more. Other way. So bring your elbows in front of you, all the way up behind you. Squeeze your forearms together and then down. Two more. Breathe in. Lift in, behind. Exhale down. Try not to arch your spine as you lift the elbows up. Notice if your ribs are flaring a bit too much. One last one. Can you not hear me? Oh, okay, good. Relax the arms down. Just roll the shoulders. We're gonna grab the block or your feet together. I'm sorry, I thought one of you couldn't hear me what was doing that. We're going to do the stretch, the sun salute, and your options are feet together or feet crossed. So see if you want to cross your feet. It's a little bit harder, but we're gonna cross the right foot on top of the left. It's all right. I am too, by the way, so yeah. So we're gonna cross the legs and squeeze our inner thighs, and if you find it too hard to cross, don't cross. Yeah, so just see if you can bend your knees there and keep a straight back today. So as you do that, if I go sideways, I've got a straight back. As you exhale, try and squeeze your inner thighs and press all four corners of your feet into the floor. and then just stretch up. Okay, that's the bending position. If you can keep that and your feet on the floor, keep your legs crossed. We're gonna stretch up first, the block up and slightly back. So try and breathe in as you do that. Do a little back bend, stretch your pubic bone forward though. Don't arch too much to the bottom of your body. And then squeeze your inner thighs, bend your elbows, bend your knees, and come into a flat back. And then drop the block to the floor and come into a forward stretch. Try and get your forehead to your right knee. Now as you breathe in, look forward and stretch into a tabletop. Lovely. As you breathe out, drop the head back down. See if you can stretch a little bit more the head towards the floor. Now breathe in, bend your knees, look forward, come into a chair position. You got it, squeeze your inner thighs and then stretch all the way up with your legs together, ideally, your feet on the floor. Open up the chest, little back bend, and then to the chest center. We do that again. So we're gonna breathe in, lift the arms up, let your back, stretch, and then exhale, bend your knees, bend your elbows. All the way down, put your hands on the floor or on the block, relax the head down, try and get your forehead to your knee, and then breathe in, stretch your back. Can you hold it here this time? Maybe with two hands on the block, maybe you can put your left hand in the middle of the block and lift your right hand up and do a twist. That's it. Push your right hip back and down to the floor. Jakob, that's it. And then drop the arm down. Can we do two more, guys? Breathe out as you lift. Push the right hip back towards the back of the room. And then back down. Last one. Hold it up. 8 seconds, maybe seven. Look up if you can. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And drop the arm down. Lovely. Relax the head for a second. Then come into a chair position. Bend your knees. Squeeze your inner thighs. Look forward. All the way up. Let your back. Open the chest. And then to the center. Nice one. We'll just uncross and we'll go to the other side. Yes? Now you know the structure. See if you can cross the left foot over the right, but if not, just keep them uncrossed, yes? Squeeze your inner thighs. Try bending your knees a couple of times, squeezing your feet down and your knees together. Make sure that happens. And then let's go for it. So we're going to stretch all the way up into a back bend. Try and stretch your knees and push your pubic bone forward. And then bend your knees, look forward, bend your elbows. Flat back down and then forward stretch. Relax the head. Breathe in. If you can come to a tabletop position, lovely. I know it's not easy, it's a balancing exercise. And then breathe out. Drop further into that forward stretch. Breathe in, look forward, straight into that chair. All the way up. Let your back. And to the chest center, nice. One more with the twist, yeah? Breathing in, make it float all the way up. Slightly back, push your feet down, guys. Breathe out, bend your knees, bend your elbows. Find your balance as you go down, forward stretch. Breathe in, up halfway. Hold it there if it gets complicated. If not, right hand in the middle, left hand up, 3 times. Look up if you can, chin in line with your left shoulder. And then back down and stretch up. Push the floor away and back down. Last one, guys, see if we can hold it. Stretch up, 8 seconds, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And drop down, well done. Relax the head first. Bend the knees, look forward, chair. All the way up. Slightly back. And to the chest center. Good. Before we finish, just grab your left foot as it's crossed over and stretch your thigh, just your thigh today. Squeeze your inner thighs, push your pubic bone forward. If you want to grab a wall, grab a wall. If not, see if you can stretch the arm up. Hug the ribs in, don't let them flare. 4 more seconds, 3, 2. Before you drop it, can you bring it forward? Maybe bring the block to the shin. Squeeze it in. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, One and drop down. Well done. Other side. So stretching, especially the groin area, the thigh. Squeeze your knees together and push your pubic bone forward. Try and keep your knees in the same line. 3, 2. That's it. And then see if you can bring it forward, find your balance. I put the block in my shin in front and then I squeeze the shin towards me. Don't know if that helps at all. Four more seconds. 3, 2, and 1. And release. Well done. Nice work. Okay, we're going to start rolling up and down to the mat. So if you want to change your camera angle, it's a good moment. Let's start rolling down. I'm giving an option to come up, so just be aware of that. A different way of rolling back, or walking back, better say. So, breathe in, just lengthen the spine. As we breathe out, rolling down, just like we have done before. You should feel a little bit more loose in the movement. Squeeze the block in between your inner thigh, Relax the head down. And then start walking to the other side of your mat, into your plank. Hold that plank position and you're gonna lift the hips up as you breathe in now into your downward dog. Bend your knees a little bit, open the chest, and then breathe out, roll into your plank. And we'll do that 3 more times. Breathing in, up and back. Breathing out, roll into your plank. That's 2. 2 more, breathing in. Breathing out. Last one. Breathing in, can you hold your downward dog as an option? See if you can bend your elbows and push yourself to your feet in one press. And then roll back. I know. So you want to try and bend your elbows and push back in one push, yeah? Rolling up as you exhale one vertebra at a time. But that's just an option to play a little bit with the movement, yeah? So we're gonna do 2 more rounds. You can always walk back. Breathe in, breathe out, roll down. And if you get tired, you can always do cat-cows rather than downward dog and plank, okay? When you're down with your hands to the floor, relax the head and walk into your plank. 4, 3, 2, 1. Hold it there. Breathe in, lift the hips. Bend the knees as much as you want. Breathe out, roll to your plank. That's 1. And again, breathing in. Breathing out. That's 2. 1 more. Breathing in. Breathing out. That's 3. And last one. Now you can hold it in your downward dog or come to your plank. If you're doing that little push, bend your elbows and push back to your feet, relax the head, and then roll up. Try to relax the arms away from your body. We're doing 1 more round. Again, you can do cat-cows. See how you feel. Breathe in. Breathing out, roll down. When you get down there, walk in. 4, 3, 2, 1. Straight away, lift the hips up, breathe in. Breathe out, roll forward. 1. Breathing in. Up and back. Breathing out, rolling forward. That's 2. Nice. Breathing in. And 3. Last one. We're still rolling up, guys. So see what you want to do. Bend the elbow. Push back. Whoop. I'll do that one again, actually. Push back. Roll up. It's an interesting way of getting back, isn't it? Nice challenge. Okay, we're going to roll down and stay on our hands and knees now. So breathe in. Breathe out. Roll down. Squeeze the stomach back. Remember to use your core. The more you do it, the more you're stretching your back. Walk forward. into your plank and then drop the knees down. Make sure that your hands are right under your shoulders here. So you're really trying to push the floor away. In fact, just try sinking and pushing a couple of times so you feel the difference in those positions. Maybe Carla, walk your hands a little bit more under your shoulders. Yeah, and then just play with sinking and pushing. As you push the floor away, suck the stomach away from the floor. That's it, but try not to move your tailbone, just the stomach. And now keep pushing, and we're going to do cat-cow. So looking up as you breathe in, and breathe out, squeezing the block and rolling the spine. Keep pushing the floor away. Two, three more, breathing in. Breathing out. Two last ones. Breathing out. One more. Breathing out. Now just come into a child's pose. Take a moment there. Take the block away. And just sit back. Lengthen your arms forward. Relax the head down. Just breathe deep here. Remember that the position, you're not moving, but there's a lot of movement and a lot to stretch just by a deep breath. So breathe into the back of your body, make it open up just by breathing deeply. And as you breathe out, squeeze your stomach in and try and sit your hips back a little bit more. And again, breathing in and breathing out. Nice, walking our hands to the right side of the mat. Just for one deep breath there. Try and slide the hips a little bit to the left, relax the head. Breathe in and out to the left side of your body. And then walk far away from you to the other side, to the left. And here you're stretching the right side of your back, your sides. So breathe into the right side of your body. Nice. And then coming back to the center, roll up. We're going to swivel the legs forward straight away today and work on the core. So again, you can put the block in between your inner thighs or keep your feet about hip distance apart. Grab your legs and just stretch up here. Lengthen. And breathe out, roll back, but grab your legs still. Let that stretch your upper spine. And again, breathe in, stretch up. Breathe out, roll by squeezing the stomach in, but really pull on your legs with your hands so you're stretching your shoulders. And two more, breathing in. See if you can keep all four corners of your feet also on the floor as you do this. One more. Breathing up. Good. Keep doing that or turn it into a twist. So as you breathe out, you could go back and then reach back with the right hand, look back and come back. Inhale up and breathing out, roll. Keep twisting with the left. Keep four corners of your feet on the floor. Notice which one lifts as you twist. Exhale, roll back. Reach back, breathe in, come up. Nice. Exhaling. See, if you want to try with no legs, so stretching both arms forward and then rolling back, keeping the arms in line. And breathe in, stretch up. And exhale, reach back still with one arm. And inhale, few more. Remember to keep your feet on the floor. Last one, breathing out. And now open the chest. If you want to lift the arms all the way up, if your groins don't hurt, and then roll all the way down, exhaling. So take it slowly. Try and keep your feet on the floor. Go all the way back with the arms, breathe in, and then back up all the way. So if you find that you can't roll all the way up, maybe wedge your feet under something that grounds them, or just come up as much as you want. Yeah, breathe in at the top and breathe out as much as you can control, but as I said, rolling back. Inhale back, breathing out as you come up. Try to control the movement, breathing at the top, breathing out. Two more. Exhale, coming up, inhale at the top, and breathe out. Let's stay down now, and we'll move our arms only. So walk your feet back, and start just by taking the arms behind your head, and then by your sides, and try really squeeze in the stomach, in the ribs, the inner thighs, the block, as you breathe out. Make your core move your arms, especially your ribs sliding down. So breathe in, arms back, breathe out, arms by your sides. And keep doing that. See if you want to lift your head and shoulders also, if your neck doesn't hurt. And checking that the stomach is still squeezing back each time you do that. So you're breathing in, arms back, breathing out. Look at the stomach pushing. And again. Remember that you're reaching forward also as you come up. So try and reach forward. Squeeze the stomach in, reach forward. And then breathe in, go back. Exhale. Remember the block also. I sometimes forget to squeeze it, so you need to keep checking that you are. And try not to move your ribs off the floor, the back of your body, or your tailbone shouldn't lift up as you lift the head. So just check that. Neutral position with the hips. Let's do one more. And then exhaling, you decide if you want your head to stay up or down. You want to take the arms behind your head if it stays up or down, and then keep the head up. Exhale if it stays up. Breathe in, back, breathe out, squeeze the block. That's two. We're doing eight. Breathe in, breathe out, three. And breathe in, squeeze the stomach in, four. And breathe in. And five, and three more, and six, and seven, one more, and eight. Grab the block on the way back, breathe in, and as you breathe out, lift the leg into tabletop, and the block goes towards the shin. That's your breath out. Breathe in, take the leg down, the arms back, and then change the leg to tabletop. The left leg comes up, breathe in behind. With the arms, exhale towards the leg. And try squeezing the block a little bit to plug the shoulders down. And it's the stomach going in that will lift the leg up, remember? So really think of stomach in, leg up. Now we can add head and shoulders to this too. So if you want to lift head and shoulders, we'll do eight more. Lifting with our head and shoulders. Nice, breathe in, breathe out. Slide the shoulders down each time the arms go forward. Make sure the shoulders aren't up. Four last ones, exhale. Inhale down. Three. Two. Keep doing that movement now. We're gonna just turn it into a kick. So as you breathe out, you turn it into a kick and then bend it back down, yeah? And you can keep lifting your head and shoulders up if they're not tired, if your neck doesn't hurt. We'll do eight more. We'll try and squeeze the stomach in as the leg goes up. Breathe in, go back. Exhale, up. Breathe in, go back. Exhale. Four last ones. Keep checking that your stomach is going in. Don't let it pop out, not even a millimeter. And two last ones. Exhale up. Inhale down. One more. And inhale down. Nice, well done. Bring the ball or the block, better said, in between your inner thighs. And just put your hands
your wrists on your hip bones and your fingers on your pubic bone, and just check that they're in line so that one is not higher than the other. And that's your neutral position. So as you breathe out, you want your pubic bone to be higher than your hip bones, curling the tailbone off the floor using your core. And as you breathe in, you want to come back to neutral. So just work with that for now, squeezing the stomach in, lifting the pubic bone higher than the hip bones, and then draw up and down again. And that's called imprint. So we're imprinting the middle spine as we breathe out, and then dropping back into neutral. Two more, breathe out, imprint, and breathe in neutral. One more, breathing out. Now you could add your arms to this. So as you breathe in and drop the hips, arms go back. And as you breathe out and lift the hips into a imprint, arms go by your sides. And again, breathe in, you can drop back, breathe out, lift. And again, breathe in, and breathing out. And you could add your head and shoulders to that now. So you could lift your tailbone, your head and shoulders, so just your middle spine is on the mat, and then breathe in, take them back. So see how far you want to take it, and let's do eight more. Breathing in, going back, breathing out. Breathing in, and breathing out. Keep going, six more. Exhale, remember to squeeze your stomach back. Even when you lift your head and shoulders here, check your stomach, push it back with your eyes. Four last ones, breathing in. Breathe out. Three. Breathe out. Two. Last one, guys. So you're going to stay with your arms behind your head, the head on the floor, and you're going to come into a full bridge. Now, so walk your feet back maybe a little bit. On the breath out, roll up. And go into a bridge position, squeezing your inner thighs as you breathe in, hold it there, and then breathe out, roll back down again, one vertebra at a time. So curl in, back to the floor. And again, breathe in, breathe out, rolling up. Squeeze the stomach in, then lift the hips, middle spine, upper spine. Hold it there, stretch, squeeze your inner thighs, and then roll back down. Breathe in at the bottom, breathe out as you roll. Squeeze the stomach, inner thighs. Go all the way up, stretch the hips. Breathe out, roll down. Breathing in. Breathe out, we've got three more. Try to see if you can lift each time a little bit higher. Breathe out, roll down. Breathe in, breathe out, roll up. Breathe in, and roll down. We've got this last one, we're going to stay up. So as you breathe in, breathe out, roll up to stay up. Maybe you can walk your feet a little bit closer to your shoulders. Squeeze the block all the time. Maybe you can walk your shoulders closer one to the other. And we're going to lift the heels up. Breathing in, that's it. Breathe out, press the heels down, but keep the hips high. And again, breathe in, lift the heels up. Breathe out, drop them down. Squeeze the block, breathe in. Breathe out, down. Breathe in, up. Breathe out, down. Four more. Breathe out, down. And three. Breathe out, down. And two. Breathe out, down. Last one. Breathe out, down. Good. Keep the hips high. Breathe in. As you breathe out, roll all the way down. Nice. Hold it there. Just see if you can lift the legs up. We're going to twist, but keep the block in between your inner thighs. Open the arms out. And then drop the knees towards the right. Look towards the left. And just let yourself twist. Still holding the block, yeah? So as you breathe out, squeeze the block. Come back to center. And then go to the other side, breathing in, Breathing out, come back to center. Breathing in. Drop. Breathing out. So try and do at least four more. Remember that you're looking always to the opposite side to where the knees are going. And ideally your shoulders are always on the floor. And there's no, every movement is controlled. So try and control all the way down. And then exhale, stomach in, squeeze your inner thighs. Control the way up. Do two last ones there. Turning or even it out. Breathing in as you drop. Breathing out as you lift up. One more. And then coming back to center. Nice. Take the block away and see if you've got a Dyna band or anything that will help you stretch your leg. I want to work the leg. I mean, you can work without a Dyna band, but if you've got something to support, especially if your groin's hurt, try and just grab the leg and thread it through the Dyna band or the belt or some tights or a strap and just kick the leg down. And as you breathe out, kick it back up again. So you want to work on the core by sucking the stomach in before the leg even lifts off the floor. And try and keep your tailbone always grounded. So let's do eight. As you breathe in, you're dropping. As you breathe out, you're lifting up. Let's go. Inhale, drop. Exhale, lift up. Inhale. Exhale. Good. Exhale. Four more. You can always bend the knee a little bit if that feels better in your groin area. But if your groin doesn't hurt, really work on stretching the leg. So two more, yeah? Breathing in. Breathing out. Last one. Hold the leg up and just move the toes and the ankle in circles. Try not to move anything else and do as big a circle as you can. And then change the direction. So other way, big circles, toes and ankles move, nothing yet. And then stop at the center, bend your knee, breathe in. And as you breathe out, try and stretch your leg as far towards your face as possible, using your core and plugging the tailbone down. And then again, bend the leg, bend the knee and stretch it again, exhaling. Two more, breathing in, bend the knee, breathing out, stretch the knee. And again, last one, breathe in and breathing out, stretch the knee. See if you can keep it stretched and draw little circles now with the leg. So the circles are coming from the hip joint. Try and relax the head down, bring the chin down also so the back of the neck is stretched. That's it. And just draw little circles. Try not move too much the hips from one side to the other on the mat. And then draw little circles the other way. That's it. Try and make a circle, not a square or a hexagon. Do three more. Looking nice. If you can turn the leg out as you drop the leg to the side a little bit and draw a bigger circle, kick it back up. It's like a semicircle with a straight leg kick parallel. So you're turning a little bit into Charlie Chaplin, opening the leg out to the side, that's it, and then kicking it up through the center. And again, turn your leg out, Charlie Chaplin a little bit. Now notice if the opposite knee moves at all or the foot lifts off the floor, don't let that happen. Last one. Draw a circle and move that leg in the hip joint. Reverse it now. So kick down, parallel, kick down, Charlie Chaplin, as you come back to the center with the leg. And again, kick down, Charlie Chaplin. Two more. Last one. Nice. Can you keep the leg up now? and just walk up your belt, diner band, whatever you have, to your foot to lift the head and shoulders. Scratch the bottom leg maybe, and just give yourself a little pull on the leg and try to get your head to the floor again. Plug the shoulders down and just hold that stretch for a couple of seconds. Try and look to the big toe, to your big toe, once you know what you're doing. Try and stretch the bottom leg into the floor. Back of the neck long. Nice. And then just bend the knee in. Take a moment there. Take the diner band away and just squeeze that right leg, right knee into your chest. Really try and compress the leg into your chest and hold that stretch. Squeeze your inner thighs here. See how that feels. You'd sway your hips off a little bit. Stretch that bottom leg. And if you're feeling okay here, try and get your forehead to your knee. And keep it there for about 8 seconds. Squeeze your elbows in, into the ribs. And try and slide your elbows forward. That's it. Relax your shoulders down. Hold it there. 4 more seconds. 3, 2, 1. And release down. Nice. Put that foot on the floor and let's go with the other leg, the left leg, yes? Lift it up. Grab it with your diner band. We're nearly there, go on, breathe in. Drop the leg down and as you breathe out, you want to squeeze your stomach in before the leg goes up. So you really want to think, breath out before the leg lifts, stomach in. So breathe in, drop, breathe up, lift up. Inhale, exhale, up. That's 2. Exhale. 3. Keep going. So we've got 4 more. Notice if your shoulders are lifting or your chin is lifted. Try and lengthen the back of your neck. Yeah, better. 2 more. Exhale up. Inhale. Last one. If you can keep the leg up and just draw little circles with the toe and the ankle. Try not to move your knee at all. And then go the other way. Now keep the foot still and just work your knee joint. So you're bending your knee and then stretching your knee. And breathing in as you bend. Breathe out and stretch. Breathe in, bend, breathe out, inhale, exhale, 2 last ones, exhale, 1 more, exhale, keep the leg stretched now, and you're doing little circles, small circles, like a tennis ball, or like a volleyball, a ping-pong ball, maybe a volleyball. But that's if your hips are not kind of balancing or swinging from one side to the other of your mat. You need to try and keep your hips without moving. We try the other way. So you're going opposite direction, still small circles. And notice your knee, your opposite knee and foot, are they moving at all? You should try to not let them move at all. Keep them super still. So we've got 3 more. And 2 more. And 1 more. Now try and make those circles big. So you're going to do a Charlie Chaplin. And then a kick all the way up and back. That's it. Breathing in as you drop. Breathe out. Kick up. Breathe in. 1 more. Breathe out, kick up. Let's go the other way. So you're kicking down as you breathe in. Charlie Chaplin as you open up to straddle and back up. 2 more. Breathing in. Breathe out as you come back to the center. Squeeze your inner thighs. Last one. Hold the leg up and see if you can walk as high as possible towards the foot. Keep that grip. And then drop the head and shoulders back down if you can. Hold that stretch. Think of the bottom leg now stretching into the floor. If you can, keep looking at your big toe, that's of the left leg. Breathe deeply, pull a little bit more. And then take the Dyna band away, just bend the knee, bring it to your chest, squeeze it in there. Really try and compress the left leg into your chest. Yeah, with that right leg, you wanna flex the foot and imagine you're standing on it, so really stretch your knee so much your heel might come off the floor. And then forehead to left knee, 8 seconds there. Sliding the shoulders down, squeezing the elbows in. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And drop it down. Nice, well done. Open the feet up about wider than your mat. And just let your knees drop to the right. With your feet and your knees quite wide. See if you can open your arms in a cross or scarecrow kind of position. And just hold it there. Try and just stretch your left hip up and your left shoulder down. And if this feels good, you want a little bit more, you could try grabbing your right shin and bring it to your right armpit with your hands interlaced. Yeah, I grab my shin with both and then I put my left hand back onto the floor. I keep my twist. And I keep my right hand grabbing my right shin to my right armpit. And keep pushing your left knee down to the floor, your left hip up. You're still twisting. Can you hold it there a few more seconds? And then see if you can put that right foot, grabbing it with the left hand, on top of your left thigh so that it pushes your left thigh down to the floor. And helps you twist a little bit more. Hold that position, just walk the left foot onto the floor. It's a pigeon, right? Interlace your fingers by threading your right hand in between your legs and just come into a pigeon position. That's it, you got it. Try to push your right inner thigh away from you with your right elbow and bring your left thigh towards you by bending your left elbow. Hold it there, try and relax the head down if you can. Maybe stretch the left leg up to the ceiling if you want a little bit more. 8 more seconds, flex the toes towards your face if you can. 7, 6, press the tailbone into the earth. Shoulders also away from the ears, into the floor, and then release. Nice, well done. Shake it out, we've got the other side to do. So we're starting with our feet open and trying to twist our knees to the left, you remember? We're doing that twist first of all. Knees left, you look to the right. Now once you've found this position, if you do want more, you could always hold it there. You grab your left shin with your left hand and maybe with the help of your right. Bring it to your left armpit and then keep looking to the right. Keep doing that twist. Keep pushing the right knee down, the right hip up. Hold it there. Nice there, Yago. That's it. It's not easy. Nicely. Now see if you can put the left foot on the right thigh, and that's a little bit extra, and gently nudge it down. And hold it there, 8 more seconds. Now walk your right foot on the floor, keep your legs in that position, and come into what would be called a pigeon. So lift the right foot up maybe. Thread the left hand in between your legs, interlace the fingers, bring the right thigh towards you. Use your left elbow to push your left inner thigh away from you, yeah? And then lay down, try and keep your hips on the floor. Maybe stretch the top, the leg, the right leg, flex the toe. 8 more seconds. 7, 6, 5, 4, 1. And release it down. Well done. Just see if you can grab under your knees now and just swing yourself forward and back. Ideally, I'd like to jump into a plank and do, just to finish off, those arm and leg lifts, yeah? So if you want to jump into a plank, you want to cross your legs and shift your weight forward in with the inertia of the jump, of the swing. So you want to go back, cross, shift, and then do a little jump, if you want to. If not, just swivel and we'll end on our stomach, yeah? That's it. Reach your hands forward, forehead on the floor. You know what we're doing here. It's a very good one for spine balancing. So forehead down, lift the right leg, left arm up, breathe in as you do that. Breathe out and change. Other leg, other arm. Breathe in, lift. Breathe out, change. And keep going. You want to think actually more of lift than lifting, of lengthening, don't you? Lengthening off the floor. And that lifts you. Try and have your palms facing in. So when you land on the floor with your hands, you're landing on your little fingers. Palms still would face in. That's it. And lengthen. About 4 more and then we'll hold, yes? We're breathing in as you lengthen. Breathing out as you drop. Breathing in as you lengthen. Breathe out as you drop. 2 more. Breathe. Now, last one. Now, see if you can keep your right leg and your left arm up and just hold it there. So lengthen to lift, go on. 8 seconds of really trying to make your body long. Plug the shoulder down, but stretch your limbs a little bit more. Go on that elbow, that knee. Keep equal pressure on your hips. Try not to roll to the side or your shoulders, better. 4 more seconds, 3, 2, 1, and drop down that leg, that arm. Let's go with the other leg, other arm. Lengthen them away from each other. Really feel like you're pulling them out of your sockets, of their sockets, but then plug them back in, but keep the length of the knee, of the elbow. Try not to lean to one side. I think, Jacob, maybe you need to push your left hip down to the floor, yeah. Keep your shoulders also equal pressure, nipples, everything. 4, 3, 2, 1, and drop down. That looked better. 2 legs, 2 arms. We're nearly done. So one big lengthen and breath in and keep breathing and lengthen everything off the floor except for the forehead and the hips for 8 seconds. Nice there, Carla. See if you can slide the shoulders now a little bit more down towards your hips and keep that length for 4, for 3, good, for 2, and 1. Drop down. Nice. Push the floor away with your hands. Come into a cat position and then into a child's pose. Through a cat into a child's pose. And just breathe deep here. A few deep breaths. Really trying to get into those little muscles of the back that are just stretched by breathing deeply. You can't move and stretch them. You need to breathe to stretch them. So take your breath to the back. Breathe out, try and sit the hips back. And again. And when you're ready, rolling up. And find a comfortable sitting position. We're going to stretch the right leg forward and the left leg back. And do 3 mermaids on each side, because we've just got time. I thought we were out of time. 3 mermaids, a hold, 3 mermaids, a hold, and then a breath good to say goodbye. So you're gonna keep the right hand right under the right shoulder here and try and lift up onto your shins. So you want to stretch the groin area, the chest, reach sideways, that's your breath in, and breathe out, drop back down. That's it. And again, breathing in, lifting up. Good. Breathing out, dropping back down. I like your version, Carla, and actually it is a version. But just so you know, We're sitting with the leg, the right leg forward. So you're sitting in between or behind your legs. But actually, we could do that one day. It's harder. It's harder. Walk your hand a little bit further under your shoulder and let's hold one up. So you're going to breathe in, lift up to hold up. That's it. 8 seconds there. 7, 6, 5, 4. We try and push the chest a little bit further towards the ceiling. Turn it towards the ceiling. That's it. 2, 1, and then drop down. Swivel the legs to the other side and do 3 more. So if you keep a little bit of a gap between them, that's it. And then grab or put the hand, the left hand, under the left shoulder. Lift up and try and push the hips forward and up. That's it. And then exhale, drop down. Do 2 more. Try not to sink into that left shoulder now. Keep pushing the floor away. Relax the head. And then breathe out as you drop. Got 1 more, yeah? Breathe in it, lift up. Can you hold it there? Try to relax the head. Take the arm behind your ear if you can. Open the chest a little bit to the ceiling. That's it. Just hold it there. 4 more seconds. 3, 2, 1, and drop down. Nice. Now come to a comfortable sitting position. We'll just finish breathing deeply together. So interlace your fingers and just try and stretch up. Lengthen your spine. Find space. As you breathe out, just roll back a little bit. Come into a cat-like position. And yeah, plug the shoulders down from your ears, away from your ears. And then again, breathe in. Stretch up. Breathe out. Roll back. Last one. Breathe in. Stretch up. Breathe up. Roll back. And now stay up as you breathe in. Try and really find a bit of more length in your spine. Wriggle up. And as you breathe out, slide the shoulders down, the ribs in, stomach in, deep core, palms together. And thank you very much, guys. Nice practice.